alcohol with the sweetening of an alcohol, or an alcohol. So we must mention the flavor. Yes, it is. So either. So you can't make a cocktail if you don't use the clean ingredients. You're gonna have no, it's true. It must have a base. So either it's a base with a sour, or a base with a sweetener, or a base with a sweetener with a sour. That's
about it. That's how Evans define. Now I will define it. A cocktail is an alcoholic drink that consists of three ingredients, which is alcohol, bitters, and sugar. That is what you will find in Wikipedia. So, if your drink will consist a spirit, a bitter, anybody knows about bitter? Angostura bitter, yeah, for example, and sugar, then you can call your drink a cocktail. That's according to the definition. So now, if you will just say, it's a mixture of several drinks, or it's a mixture of a drink, then what drink? So if I will mix rum, sugar, and water, is that a cocktail? Can I call it a cocktail? So know your basic things. You cannot just, for example, I will order cocktail to you. I will look what are you grabbing. Maybe you will grab the most expensive alcohol. Because you want to impress people. Yeah? Then you just put juice. Let's say orange. Then you just put ice. And here's the cocktail. Then I call that a cocktail. Not unless proper ingredients. Yeah?
What is the definition? Not all cocktails are the same.
Not all, yes. What I'm saying here, if you will define a cocktail, that's what it's supposed to have. Because the first cocktail that defined those words is old fashioned. Old fashioned has whiskey, bitters, and sugar. That you can classify as cocktails. Now, there are drinks that people created and they put in the mindset of people that this is a cocktail. The word passed through and through history and it's a long information.
Well, you know, just let your name so that you want to open a group, so we expand the group as yeah, just for.
So, what I'm trying to say here is that if you know the real knowledge, if you know the basic, no one can fool you. Yeah? What I'm trying to say here is that if you know the real knowledge, if you know the basic, no one can fool you. Yeah? Anybody heard about a drink called screwdriver? What does it have? What's their knowledge? People call it cocktail. But based on the definition, I don't call it a cocktail. Because it's missing one element. You got me? It's missing a bitter. But there's a bartender who created this drink and then called it a cocktail. Then one person gossip, it's a cocktail, it's a cocktail. Until now, our new generation knows it's a cocktail. But when we define cocktail, because one day you will go on a competition and you need to know the criteria of what you're making. Yeah? So, in order to make cocktail, you know already the basic ingredients. So that's what you need to look at. Does your drink have bitters? You check. Does your drink have spirit? Yes. Does your drink have sugar? Yes. Then it's, you can call it a cocktail. You can confidently fight for it. That this is a cocktail. But only it will differ now on the taste of what will it put. Because you cannot just mix drinks the way you think you want it. Every spirit has a base. Like what is the base spirit, the base of rum? Sugar cane. Yeah, molasses. So what are the, what do you think will go well with rum, for example? So sugar cane, you will think it's sweet, yeah? So now you have the element of sweetness there already. What is the next thing you would add in the rum? Something what? Sour. So for example, what are the sour? Nine lemon. But then, some people already do that cocktail. We call that daiquiri, yeah? But as you, what will you add more? Because you're calling yourself mixologist, meaning you can be able to make signature drinks, right? So, you need to understand what will go well. What sour next, yeah?
When you say bitter,
yeah.
Are you, do you mean bitter in terms of taste, or do you mean bitter in terms of infused drinks?
When I say bitter, it's a classification of a drink. One perfect example is Angostura. Another example is what you see on the back there, Campari. It is classified as bitter. Yeah? It's something that they use the peel of the fruits to create that spirit. They don't they use the essential oils. So meaning, you can make a homemade bitter, yes, but I would not really advise on that. Because if you make homemade, she makes homemade, he makes homemade, will we have a consistency? You got me? That's why brands are important. That's why when you create a signature drink, for example, I would make an angel drink. I will know that if you make an angel drink, you will have the same drink. Because we use same brand everything. We together. Like, my sugar syrup is different from your sugar syrup. For me, if I make sugar syrup, I boil half and half. If I put 1 liter of water, 1 liter of sugar, but at the end, I use a peel of oranges and lemons. I drop it there. That's how I make my homemade sugar syrup. That's my signature. So when no one can copy. So there are things that you do not to be copied. You got me? Like, maybe you will one day make a syrup and you will put spices. That it will give element to your drink. And I will do it more. So I have to look for that certain person to make that drink because no one else can make it. You got it. That's the importance of homemade and bottled. So list the things that are the bitters because there's a lot of bitters. Like Eugene, how many types of bitters you have?
Around 12. Moment, 12.
12 types of bitters. It's not only Angostura. What are the flavors you have?
We have lemon, we have chocolate, we have peach, we have bogart, we have celery, we have creole, which is like a spicy chili kind of bitters. So it all depends with what you're creating, essentially. So
there's a lot of bitters, but people maybe think there's only Angostura bitters, yes or no? But there is. You need to put your hands on the research. Yeah? And as long as you have bitter, as long as you have the sugar on the drink and a spirit, then I will respect that drink, personally. I can really say, let me taste your cocktail. So, as you as a bartender, you need also to know the bartenders you work with. Don't just call drinks cocktail because they are mixed together. No. Learn the basic, go to Wikipedia. Just type cocktail, then the definition will be there. Start self-learning. I think for me, I'm in the group, so if you have any question, you just give shout out. Because normally, everybody knows what happened to Dusit. Have you heard what happened to Dusit Hotel? Yeah. So luckily, I'm not there on that moment. Brian was there. So we're really fortunate to be here. And I think I still live because there's so much purpose for me. So I hope I can help you guys. We're on the same boat. Curiosity is the key. If you have questions, you need to ask. That's how I started. Like I can say, if I traveled so far now 10 countries, what is my difference to you? Yeah? So I hope knowledge will be your priority and not just grabbing the drinks. Because the purpose will be different.
Which she only mentions it as a cocktail, but you say that as per your explanation, that doesn't fit.
That's something
yes.
That
doesn't fit. Which can be the right term to tell the person?
If a drink
cocktail
is without alcohol, you call it as mocktail. Mock. M-O-C-K. Mocktail. It's like, you know what is mock means? Like mocking. Like joking. So it's like they want to show off. That's the history about it. So it is possible, but if you're having a client, let the client, customer is always right for me. Let the client define, but you need to have the better understanding that what you're making there is without alcohol. People will call it cocktail, yeah? Some people, on my experience, okay, for example, simple coffee order. I want cappuccino. Everyone knows cappuccino. Yeah? I want cappuccino, no foam. What will I tell to the guest? Can I tell them, excuse me, cappuccino has foam, blah, 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 blah. No, I will make the drink. But I will tell the right term afterwards. I will not do it on the series. Because internationally, a standard is that you need to be able to serve the drink within 5 minutes. So if you have already consumed 2 to 3 minutes just talking about if she's saying it's wrong, no, do first, make your drink, and then actually, you know, you can call this next time mocktail. Because cocktail has blah, 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 blah. Then you disappear. So you need to know when is the right timing to talk to the guests, because they are the one paying for the drinks, yeah? They are the one who are, they're always right. But at the back of their head, they're wrong. But you twist the thing. Like I said, it's a stage. Bar is a stage. You need to compose yourself and give proper information. That was a good question. I hope no one is making an alcoholic cocktail here. Yeah.